Hey everyone, today we have a reading here about your ex, alright? Hence the funny thumbnail, I hope you guys enjoy that. Here we go, here are the piles, we have six choices today. Find out what your ex is up to, what they're doing, right? Just a reading here before the all signs on Friday. So pile number one, we have the Brook game controller converter for PlayStation 4. We have the albuterol pump for pile two. Pile three, we have the Allen key. Pile 4, we have the wall charger. Pile 5, we have the Bina Rose Balm. And pile 6, we have the red dye. The timestamps are in the description box in the comment section. Pick your pile. I'll see you on the other side. Bye. Hey, pile 1. This is going to be your reading for what your ex is doing right now. Alright, so let's see what we get. Those of you who chose the Brook controller converter for PlayStation 4. This is your reading. Okay. So, let's see what we got, huh? For romance angels, express your love. Love yourself first. Okay, so I'm saying this was like a relationship that had a lot of imbalance when it came to affection. Maybe it was like hot and cold, very hot and cold relationship where a person's identity kept getting mixed up, you know. Someone maybe loved hard to the point where they lost their identity or they felt confused about it, what to do afterwards. Maybe the relationship became so serious, it was going into such a serious direction that it posed serious questions. People started to really think, am I really going to be here forever with this person? Am I ready for that? Or they started to question themselves or their own worth based on what was happening in the connection. Okay, let's see what your ex is up to with your tarot cards. Queen of Wands upright. Your ex could be a fire sign. Ten of Cups upright. And the Tower reverse. Okay. I feel like your ex is really avoiding you, but they're trying to make their life work out better. I'm seeing this person is planning on getting married, or they're getting a lot of attention from others, but this person has a very committed energy on their mind. They're going towards that. I feel like situation between you and them is kind of unresolved though, because there was like a big fight, the Tower reverse, there was like a big fight, and your ex just stopped talking. They stopped communicating for some reason. I'm seeing like the romance angels are maybe telling you to express your love first toward them. Maybe this person was falling hard for you first, and now they took their energy back. I'm seeing this person is in their power, Queen of Wands. People are trying to talk to this person. Things around this person are growing. This person is looking very attractive to male and female. They could have a black cat, or some kind of cat. This person could also be taking care of their family. I'm seeing they may have quit a job or something like that. It could be like that. If this is not them separating from you, this could be they may have quit their job or they have a problem with their boss. They find them very tyrannical or unfair or something about it. But I feel like it's with you though. I feel like you guys had to like destroy everything you built on so that you could start over. But I feel like your ex is not like starting over in your direction. I feel like they're starting over in general. They may be taking care of their parents, or maybe they have a kid on the way. This person just wants happier days in their life now. Okay, let's see from these cards what it means for you. Okay, clarify the Tower reverse. What happened between pile one and the ex? Why was the Tower reverse there? Pile 6 may also resonate for you. The red die was here. Ace of Wands upright and the Judgment. I think, you know, this person made a decision to go for something new because they felt like you were causing anxiety. This person feels like there was a lot of deception in the situation. I feel like this person finally decided they couldn't trust you anymore. They wanted to build something brand new. They made a final decision because they suffered a lot about it, and I feel like they found out things about you and about how you envision a relationship. And this person called it quits because it was bringing them a lot of pain. 5 and the 9 of Swords, 5 to 9. You could have known this person 5 to 9 years, or there could be 5 to 10 years, or there could be. It was a serious separation. This person wanted a relationship, but I feel maybe you wait made them wait for a relationship. And this person knows their worth, so they're not waiting for anyone for anything. I feel like this person knows what it takes to make a good relationship with the High Priestess and the Four of Wands. I feel like all the pain that happened in this relationship got them ready for their next relationship, pretty much. If you love this person, tell them you love them. But I feel like this person thinks of you positively sometimes, but they know that the relationship isn't gonna work between you two, even though they may have thought it was a good match. I feel like they feel you're not a fair person. That's their opinion of you, really. You're not a fair person. They are doing well for themselves in career, and they have options. They're focused on settling down. This is what your ex is doing. And your ex is also doing what they can to make the rest of their life fair. I see that they're paying back people they may owe money, or they are making things even between them and their past. They're transforming. Your ex, Palwin, is transforming and transforming for the better. You guys are not talking right now because you're taking this opportunity to love yourselves first. There was some manipulation in the situation, but all in all, there's a conversation that hasn't been had. This is a story I'm seeing between you and your ex. Okay? Like, share, and subscribe. Comment on my video if you feel like it. And personal readings are back open. Check them out. Aceofchalices.net, pickapile.com. Love you guys, alright? Bye. Hi, guys. Those of you who chose the albuterol asthma pump, this is going to be your reading for what your ex is up to, what are they doing right now, how they're feeling about you. We're going to go into the romance angels right now. Let's see. Let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others. And chemistry. There's a strong magnetic attraction here. Okay, so what I'm seeing is maybe you have yet to make a next move because you don't know how it will be received. I'm seeing there's people you may have told about your connection, and sometimes you doubt their advice, but maybe your perspective is what's getting you a certain type of result. So if you want to get better results, it's telling me to ask. You should ask for some advice. But I guess that's kind of what you're doing here, right? Let's go into the tarot. Knight of Swords, Five of Wands, and the Page of Pentacles reverse. Okay. I'm seeing this is a connection that started off very fast. It could have been only a sexual connection. I feel like your ex is dealing with a lot of other people right now. We're gonna look deeper into what that means, but what I'm seeing is that there could have been, like, this person is smart, like, they're intelligent, but sometimes they bite off more than they can chew. I feel like this person can be lazy sometimes. They have a track record of breaking promises. Like, they're not that. Like, I get a feeling this ex of yours, they break promises to you for people younger than them or friends. They may break their promise because of something new that comes up, something fun that comes up. They're very dramatic. This person is in the middle of drama. They speak drama, they walk drama, they talk drama. When drama comes to them, they don't fix it. You know, it's kind of like this kind of energy. I feel like you know that there's chemistry between you and your ex, but you feel like they're too immature. They're too lazy about details, like to hash out why you guys are having a difference. They're lazy in that. Instead, this person's more like a name caller. Like, once you get them past a certain threshold, they're just gonna call you names and say, "Oh, my friend doesn't do like this." So what I'm getting is when you guys fight about something real, they go to hang out with their friends and waste their time or something. I don't know. Does that end GMC? So you want to ask your friends about your ex. Right now, what your ex is doing is they're running around a lot of places trying to look important, feel important, but I feel like they're just dealing with a lot of drama. It's a lot of talking, gossip. or some conflict at the workplace. So maybe wherever they're going is very argumentative or competitive. Like, they have to talk around with a lot of people, and sometimes they get their way, sometimes they don't. But your person is very sharp. They know what to say. They know how to push your button. I'm seeing they are pretty bad at damage control, but they have a mouth on them, basically. All right, let's see what's going on in here. Clarify the Knight of Swords. What had happened? What were they saying? Three of Pentacles upright. Okay, maybe this person was very quick to tell you they have a relationship with somebody else, or that they have a kid on the way or something. They could have told you this. Some details came out about... Okay, I'm seeing that this person may have been hiding a relationship the whole time. I think this came out with the Five of Wands again, Ace of Swords upright, and the Ten of Pentacles. This person could have been hiding their whole connection from you, or their intentions to start new. It's like when this person dumped you or broke up with you, like, you kind of saw it coming in some way. I'm getting it back. Like, you knew it was fair. Like, you knew that they're not going to be where you're ultimately happy. You find that they think they're smart, but this person betrayed you. So, like, I feel like this person betrayed you. They think they're smart, but they actually bit off more than they can chew, and they're not having a great time right now. They walked into more drama. They thought when you argue that, you're just being difficult, but this person ain't see how you were trying to help them, right? You're trying to help them become more stable, and this person took it out on you instead. And this person's not surrounded by positive people anymore. See, you were the positive person in this person's life, right? You kind of had a situation that was very growing very well. There may have also been another business partner with you in this. And it was going good. But I feel like somewhere along the line, this person felt threatened by you, your ex. They felt threatened. So they didn't want to step up to the next level of responsibility. So instead, they just hung out with people who don't tell them no. Right? And now they're seeing that even less is happening. Even less stuff is happening, moving. It's less reliable. This person really just ran into a ditch. Like, they fell into a ditch. And they're waiting for you to say something, but you're at work. You're too busy working on yourself and your job to care about them. And they did actually do a number on you. They told you a very harmful thing that made you want to be alone. Whatever they said to you, it made you want to be alone. And maybe you also, like, you thought about, you may have had a fling, or then you may have thought about how you would want to settle down. It was a totally different side of you. And you were shocked as well. But you're ready to do something new. You don't care about this anymore. They want to run into a dead end. That's up to them. That's kind of how you made it. You were, I'm seeing, like, you were this, like, this asthma pump. You rescued this person from their own drama, but they were very ungrateful, and they ran right back to what they were comfortable in, instead of stepping up with you, your stability here. Okay, guys, like, share, and subscribe. AceofChalices.net, PickAPile.com. Personal readings are back open, all right? I love you. I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Hey, Pile 3, those of you who chose the Allen key, this is going to be your reading for what is your ex doing right now, what are they thinking, what are they up to, and what happened between you guys. All right, so let's see. Allen key. All right, so romance angels calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you two together. And give your relationship a chance. Work on your partnership. That was in the reverse. Let's see what we have here. Eight of Swords. Three of Cups reverse. Ten of Pentacles reverse. Give your relationship a chance. Wanted me to take it in reverse. Okay, your ex is out of their head. about this situation. They may have recently had a breakup with someone they cheated on you with, or it could be like a third party. Maybe you were getting ready to marry this person, but they went in another direction. We're going to find out what happened to them in their direction soon, but let's hear first. What is this saying? So what had happened between you two is there was a lot of discussions, right? About what to do in the future, what not to do. I'm seeing that something happened where you couldn't take this forward. Maybe you caught them talking to another person, or you've discussed something with the other person, and they made it clear to you that this connection wasn't gonna happen anymore. But we gotta see if this is about their current relationship or you guys, right? What I'm saying is that you are finding someone better. Pile three, my pile three out there, you're finding someone better. Right now, you're doing what you can to better yourself. You're getting better habits, and you're learning what went wrong in this connection. I see there were a lot of things you found ideal with this person, but some kind of promise didn't materialize, right? Maybe you didn't. The faith didn't continue. It had a good start, but the faith didn't continue. Someone juggled along the way, and now there is no relationship. Okay, so let me see something. Clarify the Ten of Pentacles. Page of Swords upright. Maybe you stalked them and found out that they have another relationship. Clarify the Three of Cups. Strength upright and the Devil in the Temple of Pentacles. Yeah, you were working on this for a long time, but something happened where it fell apart. Maybe there were some legal proceedings or some kind of official work that had to be done, and that separated you two. But I feel like both of you were very sexually attracted to each other, but a part of it was toxic. Maybe you found out that you weren't being your most authentic self some during the course of the relationship. Or maybe you felt like this person, like you couldn't be yourself around this person. Like maybe they always wanted you to change a certain way, or maybe when you argue, they would demonize you instead of get to the point, right? Like for example, if you make sense, right? But they're being dismissive about your argument, about your stance. And so your arguments, your debates are not really productive, right? They don't get anywhere. So it's like useless. It's not a truly challenging relationship. Instead, it's like, you're right, I'm right, you're wrong, that's that. Okay, if you don't want to believe you're wrong, fine, fuck it. But there's no real premise to why someone is right. They're not explaining why they are a certain way or they're not. Or they're not explaining why you should change or why you should not. It's just like, change because I said so. And if you didn't do what they said so just have someone else. It's like someone manipulative. They're actually very manipulative. Okay, so what they're doing right now is they're not confused about how they felt about you. Maybe they cut you off feeling that you are the manipulative one. That's how they told themselves. They wanted to try their other options, so they did that. Okay. How's it going with them and their options? Ace of Swords upright, a lot of like better quality communication or some kind of discussion about love. I'm seeing your ex has found love now or some kind of connection where they feel like they're getting away from you, like some kind of they feel like it's an upgrade is what I'm seeing here. They feel more connected to this person. Clarify Three Cups one more time. Four of Swords upright. Yeah, they're taking a long break from talking to you. They're happier in their new connection. Some they may be traveling soon. A part of them does feel like they didn't do the right thing to you, but they justify it because of the quality of their new relationship. Like they're comparing you. They felt like it was hard to understand you. This new person is like more similar to them, or they have more interests in what they're building with this person. It could be a fire sign. I'm seeing they're building something more stable with this person, and they trust the situation more. Maybe this person shared finances with them, Ace of Pentacles, sooner than you did. But what I'm seeing for you, though, is that you're a work in progress, and you're going to be highly successful. Seven of Pentacles and Six of Wands. This person just seems like they gave up on you too quick. But it had you feeling really bad. Five of Pentacles. What should they do about it? Ten of Wands upright. I see that you have a need to reassess what deserves to be in your life and assign values to them. This completely emptied, like, you're back to the drawing board. Clear conscience, starting from scratch, and that felt really bad on you. I don't feel this person's that guilty about it, though. They just doing what's best for them. And they know that you'll do the same. They were more scared of you taking advantage of them. This person doesn't feel like the new person is doing that. So they are happy in their new relationship. If you guys want to get a personal reading, you could do that. AceOfChalices.net, PickUpPile.com. Stay tuned, guys, for more, right? I love you. Bye. Hi, Pile 4. Those of you who chose the wall charger, this is going to be your ex reading. What's going on with your ex? What are they up to? Pile 3 may resonate for you as well. The allergy? Okay. So, Pile 4. What are your romance angels? Let's see. What your ex is doing right now. Make the effort and pay attention to the red flags. Ace of Wands reverse. Five of Swords upright. The High Priestess. Okay, I'm seeing you and your ex had a falling out over secrets. I feel like this person didn't include you in their plans. Effort died along the way. Something about it, like you guys not finishing up, happened. This could be a third party situation. I feel like someone was very reckless with the other person's trust. The situation had to do with someone taking a long break, and that was not appreciated. Someone did not get proper rest. It's been a very long distance between you two. I feel like this person kept showing you signs that they're a very addictive person. Addicted person, they're obsessive. They may have like these very self-centered habits, like making you change your day for them, or like not asking you before changing your day kind of thing. Like this person invaded your life, like I'm saying. But they invaded it. Like they started to make decisions for you, and that got you mad. Like you one by one, you just was like, you know what, I'm going to hold back from this person, and I'm going to let them expose themselves. If they're corrupt, I'm going to let it be known, I'm going to let it happen. This person never made you feel appreciated the way you wanted. You felt always it was a lack from them. They held back from you. Okay, clarify the High Priestess. This is our secrets card, but let's see what it means. Six of Cups verse. I feel like this person was holding on to another ex of theirs. They didn't want to let that go. And it kept your relationship with them stuck. You know, they weren't charging your batteries. And you realized this person was distracted. And then you called it quits with them. I'm seeing you're the one who excommunicated them. Because they couldn't let go of their other ex. So you just went in another direction. I'm seeing you may have changed your habits. If you were drinking before, you've calmed down drinking. If you were smoking before, you do less of that now. Or maybe you quit cigarettes. You cut down wasting time. I'm seeing like it put you in a spot where you don't want to share with anyone anymore. It's like it has you in a real down spot. But I feel like you are making those changes and you're ready to build again, but a part of you is still bitter about your ex. Okay, let's see. Has this person moved on? No, they haven't. Five Cups upright and the Temperance. I think this person is still waiting on you in some way, but they're still giving to other situations. They're over the anxiety of it, but they miss you. Five of Cups, Six of Pentacles, the Temperance, Nine of Swords, Reverse on the Bottom with Eight of Wands. I see they miss you, but they're not going to reach out to you because I feel like you kind of... You really shed light on this person. You let them know that they're the problem. So they don't really know how to talk to you. Are they happy in that connection they left you for? No. These people... It ended as fast as it started. I'm seeing these two people both are trying to manipulate each other. They don't have real intentions of fixing each other's lives. They're lying to each other. Already cheating on each other. Most likely. Already. They knew that they're not good for each other. But it messed up your connection with them. But at the same time, if you kind of knew that, so you took yourself out of a situation that was only going to get worse, is what I'm seeing. And you're starting over. Page of Pentacles upright, Ace of Pentacles reversed. This person could have stolen money from you. Or some of your personal belongings. Or they could have damaged your property. I'm seeing you're not looking back in the sense of that, but you have love for this person. You wanted to marry them. You find them dangerously sexy, but they are not... Not only are they not good for you, this person has value issues. Like, I don't think that they know what they do matters to everyone. I think they think that everything doesn't matter. This is a very careless person with people's life. They only care about their life, and they don't even care about that much at all. Because if they did, they would nurture their wealth, like their relationships. This person is immature. They just go to who says yes to them, basically. And I'm seeing this person is in heavy imbalance because of it. A lot of their life has become imbalanced because they spread their energy too thin. And then no one really has their best interests. It's just all superficial relationships that are not involved in your life enough to give a fuck about it. Like, they're never going to be able to give you the best advice if they don't know what your day is like. They're never going to be able to be in your shoes unless they have been there or they have known someone who's been there. If you're only dealing with someone who's criticizing your journey and giving you short-term solutions, they're not taking you in account when they're giving you that advice. Someone has to slow down with you and talk to you on your terms. What do you find important to ask you about that? Because their advice is not going to fit every person's life, unfortunately. Even if it's a similar situation, sometimes the advice is not applicable. I feel like this person is getting to know themselves, but I don't think you two are in the same direction. You know? And if you're in the same direction, you're just not on the same path. This person gave you a lot of red flags and you got out. It was pain to get yourself out when you could, but you still were able to do it. And starting over is annoying for you, but you're having faith in doing that. Guys, want to book a personal reading? You could do that. Pickapile.com, makesachalices.net. I love you. I'll see you in the next one. All right, guys. Bye. Hi, Pile 4. Those of you who chose the Rose Bomb, the Vina Rose Bomb, we are going to dive into this pick a card reading. What is your ex doing now? Let's grab the romance angels first. New love. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. And let go of control issues. Allow the situation to unfold naturally. Okay, so what I'm seeing here is you guys separated because maybe you felt like you weren't the best fit for each other anymore. Maybe someone had trust issues in the situation. And because of that, maybe you guys couldn't agree on certain rules or how to ground the relationship in general. Okay, so let's see what the tarot is. Page of Swords upright. Both of you are stalking each other. Four of Swords. Okay, so Page of Swords, Two of Pentacles reverse, and Four of Swords. So, what is your ex doing right now? Right now, your ex is getting information on you. And they already have some information on you. And not only that, they have information that you may have a new lover on the horizon. And or already. Like, they are wondering, maybe if you have a person, they've gotten word of that information. Yeah. I think this person was very controlling. So they're still also trying to control your life in some way, even though they're not your boyfriend, your girlfriend anymore. Like, they want to control your life in some way. They feel like it was out of control. Like, sometimes they daydream about, they wouldn't want it to be with you forever. They actually did have that vibe, or they seemed that way, but I feel like you realize this person was unstable, and their instability got you sick. You fell sick because of it. Some part of you, I think in April, you had a really hard time, or maybe 4 months ago, which could be in January or December. So, you needed a break. And that break got so good that you were just like, you know what? I just need to go somewhere else, man. And you just took yourself and you took yourself somewhere else. Because the longer you took this break, the more peace you felt. So you realize this person was the chaotic one. They're too controlling. Maybe they always have some shitty opinion about where you're going, who you're seeing, what you're doing, what you're not doing, where you're going today, where you're not going today. Can you drive them somewhere? And I think that you also found this person very sneaky, emotionally unavailable, and that revealed itself slowly and surely, right? It slowly revealed itself on you, Rosebaum. I'm saying you're a pretty, you're a really cool person. You're someone very well-learned about life, about the world, maybe different religions. You have a lot of different knowledge on those things. You're someone very psychic as well. You're someone who knows how to design and maintain their own happiness. It's like this other type of person may have gotten in your way, or they started to bring their instability into your life. They try to confuse you with your stuff. Like, maybe you would just hang out with your friends. Sometimes this person would give you a hard time, even though you took care of their needs. Like, this is the kind of energy I'm seeing here with the Ten of Pentacles, the Three of Cups, Queen of Cups, here, the Sun. See, you're happy whether you're in a connection or not. And I'm seeing that energy is bringing you closer to this new love. Everything about you is getting new love. Because maybe you've changed the parts of yourself that were similar to this person. You know, maybe you used to be more similar to them, but now you're not. Like, now maybe you have less control issues. You're more trusting of the unknown rather than just like becoming a bigot, you know, and saying, oh, all women are bad, all men are bad. Like, you're not a bigot. You like, or you let go of any little piece of you that may have had that kind of presumptive attitude about others, right? Maybe you let go of that and now you're like, you know, if there's new people in my life, that's a good thing, right? Because you're feeling like that's a sign that life is going on, right? You're not like trying to see or feel like, since you had a hard time then, that, oh, do you just have like bad luck, full stop? No, it's not like that, right? Not for you. And you're seeing the glass half full. You're generally that kind of person. Maybe this thing had you down for a while. I see like this situation with this ex, it had you very, was the word I'm looking for. It had you very distant from people. I wanted to say you went into solitude. And you became somewhat of a, you weren't outcasted by the people. You took yourself, a recluse, that's the word I'm looking for. You became a recluse to better yourself. I'm seeing some time with your friends, if you hung out with your friends for a while, and after a long time, and that made you realize what makes you feel wealthy. You felt wealthy when you're like with your family, just having a good time. With this card that just fell down, he just sort of, your ex can't stand that. Like, your ex is probably younger than you, maybe, you know. They look for information, they found it, they're still looking. Clarify the Page of Swords. Yeah, they feel like it's very unfair that you walked away. They feel like you're one of the smartest people they knew. You could be a Libra or a Leo, Virgo as well. They're really feeling like life is unfair about it. They wish that they could go back to a time when you were under their thumb or something like that. Like, this is how the person would say it. Like, your ex is kind of vile, right? They're like taking cheap shots at your success. Like, your success was like getting away from them. Not for the Four of Swords. Yeah, I feel like it did take a while for you to decide that, but once you made that decision, it was very clear to, you know, not be with them anymore. You had another option, a better one. You chose your career over them after a while, and sometimes you would think about them a lot because some parts of the situation were not resolved, but I'm seeing like the pain was so great from the past that you're kind of like settling for that, even if there is no closure, like settling for no closure. Like, you don't kind of mind anymore. It's that kind of thing. And your ex is feeling about it that you have moved on. From all the information they have gathered, they're like, yo, this rose balm? Pile 4? No, 5. Pile 5? Oh, I said pile 4. Pile 4 may resonate for you. Pile 5 here? They're thinking, yeah, you moved on. You're gone for good. They can see from your pictures that they were able to tell from your social media trends, right, that you did grieve them. And then they were able to tell from your social media trends that you're over it. They're seeing you as, with your whole life ahead of you, Eight of Pentacles, Page of Wands, you're just ready to get whatever you want in life. And so that's what your ex is doing right now. They're watching you live your life, and they're watching you love living your life, and they're watching you, and they're pretty bitter about that. They're pissed. Alright? I'll see you, right? Love you guys. If you guys want to book a personal reading, you can do that. aceofchalices.net. Okay. Take care. Bye. Hi, pile 6. This is going to be your pick a card reading. Let's see what number you got. 5. Big change. Pile 6, you got 5. Let's see. From the Romance Angels. What is your ex doing right now? Wedding. And romantic feelings. Okay, this situation involves marriage and romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. Okay, so I think your ex is going toward marriage. Okay, let's see. 8 of Pentacles, 4 of Pentacles, Page of Cups reversed. Okay, I'm seeing this person could be our sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. They are really busy with family right now. 4 of Pentacles, 8 of Pentacles. I feel like they don't have time for love anymore. Maybe you are falling for your ex more and more these days, but this person is like a cold fish now. Or maybe like you left them because they're very like unreliable when it comes to matters of love. They have they're well off financially, but you feel like you can't trust them. Maybe this person hit a pregnancy. Yeah, the Empress and upright, Page of Cups reversed. This person could have broken your heart with a pregnancy or hit a pregnancy. I'm seeing something really about a pregnancy that happened. Or maybe they're marrying someone, they got pregnant, but they're not in love with that person. I don't know. I feel like this person has a lot of abusive habits. Like, they may be into substance abuse, or they could have some addiction that stops them from changing to their higher potential. But this person is learning better about financial literacy and their education, so they're going to take themselves out. Maybe they're in debt right now, but they're like making the waves to fix that. They're very smart. Your ex is a very smart person, but they could be very bad with money, or they make bad investments, so they had bad luck with that. I'm seeing in the recent past they just lost a lot of money over something, so this person is like working really hard to repair those damages. Maybe you had a divorce and they're paying you an alimony or something like that. But now that the divorce is happening, maybe you're still in love with your partner. It's like now that the divorce is final, or like you're getting closer to the divorce, it's like maybe you feel that was some part of stability that's gone now. But you're feeling hopeful that you can recover or find someone. That's how you may be feeling. How does this person feel? Let's see. How's your ex feeling? What are they doing? Ten of Pentacles. This person is really feeling the financial loss about it, but they're trying to do something. Maybe they're working from home online. They really lost a lot of money online. Maybe they lost a lot of money online. Maybe they put a lot into crypto and they sold before they they sold it before it went back up, right? So they just lost money anyway and cut their losses. I think they may be going through a problem because of an affair, your ex. They're going through a problem right now because of an affair. Maybe there is a pregnancy now because of that. That's what I'm seeing. I'm seeing some kind of secret affair is going to be known. And it's going to be in a public place. Oh, sheesh. An affair is going to be known in a public place. What the hell? Three of Pentacles. Queen of Cups. Yeah, someone is a very distorted feminine energy. They sleep around to not feel stuck. Who is this? Two of Wands. I feel like your ex is moving on, but it's really hard for them to. They felt like you were the lucky thing. Wheel of Fortune, reverse, Eight of Cups upright, but you're moving on. You're moving towards your better luck stuff, but they think about that sometimes, and they hate that. They hate that you were more truthful than them in the situation. It would turned out that way. Yeah. And you're not stressing them anymore like you were. But this person, they still hold a lot of secrets, even from whoever they're dealing with now. But things are going to be coming out about this person, that they are a player, or like they emotionally abuse people. Maybe they lead people on and then they always get caught when they do it. This is someone who needs to be around people. They just love having two people at once or three people at once. They don't have true values, right? Because, why I say that, right? Why, if you're polyamorous, why I say it doesn't have values? Because if your body, right? Your body is the most personal part about you. Shouldn't that also be the most exclusive part about you? Think about it. Does everyone get to see you go to the bathroom? No. It's like this person traded in love just to see, like, just to do what they do. They traded in love. They don't know if they'll ever get it, but they take it for granted. Maybe this person just likes to go on vacation. Can't really think of anything. They feel like you were good, though. They feel like you were justice. You were fair. Okay, so then why did it go to shit? Let's see why. Yeah, this person is just not honest about their flirty behavior. They're too spread out, and this person is not very patient when it comes to fixing a relationship. When things don't go their way, they just leave it. That's what your ex is doing. Okay, what are they doing? How's it going for them? They may be getting married to somebody else, or may be married already. Still stuck in a marriage that they don't like, possibly with a Taurus, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Cancer. Pile 6. What is the ex doing right now? King of Cups upright. They're thinking about you in some way. They're thinking about... Alright, here are the three. They're thinking about all things you guys have been through. I feel like they have a better sense of what your love meant now that you're gone. This person thinks about it. This could be a same-sex relationship. This person thinks about all the good times that you should. Alright, so what I'm seeing here is that your ex is currently stuck in a relationship they're not happy in, or lost a lot of money in a divorce. The other side of that, this story, is that your ex thinks about the good times you had, but they are accepting that their life is not like that anymore. They're accepting that they don't have love in their life, and they maybe feel obligated to either keep a baby or having to devote themselves to the person who's pregnant, or since they're pregnant now, they're going to settle down. Could be like that. Let's see, one more card to see. For the Page of Wands upright, I feel like there's going to be a blocked off wall of communication. You guys aren't speaking anymore because of how things ended. What's going on with my pile of six? Let me see something. What's going on with my pile of six? You're just hard at work trying to fix whatever you've lost out of this relationship. You don't want to lose any more time about it. I see that you yourself are getting committed or run a family right now. Things are going good for you, and you're going to keep it that way. You want to become more and more exclusive as the days go by. You're changing your attitude. You feel elevated nowadays. Maybe you're going back to school. I'm seeing you spend time with your folks as well. And you may be channeling away bad habits. Okay, guys, if you love this reading, you can get a personal one at aceofchalices.net. I'll see you guys on the next one. Thanks for joining me again. Take care, right? Pickapile.com, aceofchalices.net.